Good evening, doctors, and good evening, online viewers. I am very thankful those who are watching online for me, my lecture. Okay, my dear friends, our today's topic is pregnancy-induced hypertension, is PIH. Another name is gestational hypertension. Its another name is gestational hypertension. In definition, here the BP must be systolic more than 140 and diastolic must be more than 90 mmHg. If the pregnancy week is gestational age is more than 20 weeks, and then hypertension more than 2, 3, 4 episodes is known as pregnancy induced hypertension. But here, no proteinuria. There is no proteinuria. Okay, in preeclampsia, we are going to know the pregnancy induced hypertension here, plus there is proteinuria, the loss of protein in a urine more than 3 grams per day 24 hours. Marker is working very bad, no problem. Another fire. Then syndrome. In preeclampsia, there is a syndrome known as HELL, H-E-L-L-E-P, HELP. H represents here hemolysis of RBCs. E-L represent E for elevated, L for liver enzymes. Elevated liver enzymes help, and there is no E between them, it's H-E-L-L-P, help. Okay, so here LP, it represents low platelet count, less than 25,000. Okay, my dear friends, then we are going to know about eclampsia. Eclampsia is pregnancy induced hypertension with preeclampsia proteinuria. We can say preeclampsia plus tonic clonic seizures. It represents the eclampsia. So, my dear friends, now till here we understood. Pregnancy-induced hypertension is a hypertension when a pregnancy gestational age is more than 20 weeks and the systolic pressure is more than 140 and diastolic must be more than 90. But no proteinuria in pregnancy-induced hypertension. But in case of like preeclampsia, there is proteinuria in pregnancy-induced hypertension, common. Proteinuria must be more than 3 grams per 24 hours. Then another one is, in case of eclampsia, there is symptoms of pregnancy-induced hypertension with preeclampsia, but here it's included tonic-clonic seizures in eclampsia. Okay, so risk factors for pregnancy-induced hypertension, my dear friends, is obesity. Obesity is a very highest risk factor. If a female age is more than 35 years, it's a risk factor. If a patient has a history of hypertension, any renal disease, or diabetes mellitus, these are the risk factors. Our patient already has a history of eclampsia, preeclampsia, and PIH, pregnancy-induced hypertension. So the drug of choice in pregnancy-induced hypertension is methyl dopa. And other drugs we use in pregnancy-induced hypertension is hydralazine, labetalol, sodium nitroprusside, nifedipine can be safe, also safe. In case of eclampsia, the drug of choice is magnesium sulfate, my dear friends. Magnesium sulfate, its value must be 4 to 7 doses milliequivalent per liter. Okay, the antidote of magnesium sulfate toxicity is calcium gluconate is the antidote. What are the side effects of magnesium sulfate on neonates is respiratory distress in neonates. And we need to monitor the deep tendon reflex is the most common toxicity. Deep tendon reflex loss. And we are going to respiratory rate monitor. Deep tendon reflex, respiratory rate. And another also we are going to see here urine output. Okay, so my dear friend, till here I hope you understand. It's very easy. A definitive treatment for severe preeclampsia is go for termination of pregnancy, my dear friends. It's terminate the pregnancy. What does it mean? Means the delivery of a baby. Terminate pregnancy means deliver a baby is a final treatment, best. But if we think about the drug of choice for severe preeclampsia, the drug of choice is labetalol. Okay, first sign of pregnancy induced hypertension of eclampsia is visual disturbances. Okay, earliest sign of preeclampsia is weight gain, my dear friends. So many times they ask. WAT means I write here weight, WEIGHT, but I write as short form weight, WT gain, weight gain. Preeclampsia Doppler ultrasonography shows at the 22 weeks descent of uterine artery, DESCENT, descent of uterine. Preeclampsia Doppler ultrasonography, if we do on 22nd week, then uterine artery, 22nd week, descent of uterine artery we see. So my dear friends, I hope you understand till here. So it's a time for MCQs, and we are going to solve some MCQs. So I am going to start some MCQs. So my dear doctors, please be ready and be wake up for your answers. And now I am going to ask some questions. Question number 1, in AIMS May 2014, they ask, health syndrome, all criteria except, first option is hemolysis. In health, I already explained, health syndrome, hemolysis, elevated liver enzyme, low platelet level must be less than 25,000, and retroperitoneal hemorrhages. My question goes to Mr. Madan. Answer please.
Me.
Yes, he is absolutely right, because in health, H represent hemolysis, E represent elevated liver enzyme, LP represent low platelet, but there is no retroperitoneal hemorrhage. So he is good Madan answer. Now next question, which antihypertensive is contraindicated in pregnancy, like IV diazoxide, IV nitroprusside, IV labetalol, IV hydralazine. My question goes to Vijay. Answer please.
A.
Yes, he is absolutely right. A. Because I already explained in my theory. Labetalol, we are going to use sodium nitroprusside. We can use hydralazine, we use. But diazoxide, we are not going to use in pregnancy. It's not safe. So, okay. Next question. Management of eclampsia in 34 weeks of pregnancy. If a patient with eclampsia and 34 week pregnancy. Options are, first, continue anticonvulsion and wait for 37 week to complete. Second, wait for spontaneous labor. Third, BP continue. D, antihypertensive, anticonvulsant, and termination of pregnancy. My question goes to Dr. Sachin. Answer.
D.
Yes, Dr. Sachin is right. Antihypertensive, anticonvulsant, and termination of pregnancy. Why so? Because it's eclampsia and 34 week we can able to terminate the pregnancy, and we need to continue. Okay, another question. First sign of magnesium sulfate toxicity is First one option is loss of deep tendon reflex, respiratory depression. Second one. Third one is cardiac arrest. Fourth one is decreased urine output. My question goes to Dr. Pratik. Answer.
A.
Yes, he is absolutely right. Loss of deep tendon reflex is the right answer. Yes. Okay, my next question. Drug of choice for eclampsia. Option R. A. One is magnesium sulfate. B. Is clonazepam. C. Is antihypertensive. And D. Is beta blocker. My next question goes to Dr. Lal Singh. Answers.
A.
Yes, he is absolutely right. Is the answer. Magnesium sulfate is a drug of choice, my dear friends, for eclampsia. Okay, next question. Antihypertensive that is contraindicated in pregnancy. Option A, labetalol. Option B, hydralazine. Option C, methyldopa. Option D, ACE inhibitors. My question goes to Dr. MLA. Answer, please. Yes, he is absolutely right. He is absolutely right. ACE inhibitors are contraindicated in pregnancy. Next question, in NEET PG 2012 and 2013. Option, antihypertensive drug of choice for pregnancies. A option is methyldopa, B option is labetalol, C option is hydralazine, D option is calcium channel blocker. So, Dr. Vivek.
A.
Yes, he is absolutely right. Methyldopa is a drug of choice. Right, right. Therapeutic level for serum magnesium needed to treat preeclampsia. I already explained in my theory. This question they ask in NEET PG 2012 and 2013. So, his answer is 4 to 7 milliequivalent per liter. I already explained. So, next question, we can further go. Then, question is, a 27-year-old female, pregnancy-induced hypertension, blood pressure 150 by 100, 32 weeks of gestation, no other complication. Her blood pressure is controlled on treatment. If there are no complications, the pregnancy should be best terminated at. So, my dear friends, no need to think 37 weeks is the best for termination of pregnancy. So, go for 37 weeks if there is no complication. It's a logical question and logical answer. What is the most common observed fetal effect in women receiving magnesium? Fetal effect in a woman receiving magnesium sulfate therapy for preeclampsia and eclampsia. Listen carefully. A woman who is receiving a magnesium sulfate therapy or magnesium sulfate therapy for a fetus, we need to watch what reflex. A option is respiratory depression. B is for fetal heart rate pattern. C is for cerebral palsy. D for interstitial obstruction. My question goes to Lalu Singh.
A.
Yes, he is right. Respiratory depression, my dear friends. He is absolutely right. Okay. Then again, question. Earliest sign of preeclampsia is option A is hypertension. B is albuminuria. C is pedal edema. And D is excessive weight gain. Dr. Sachin.
D.
Yes, he is absolutely right. Excessive weight gain is the answer. D1 is the correct. Okay. Another question. Drug of choice for pregnancy. Already repeatedly they ask question. The single most effective drug in eclampsia. Also repeatedly magnesium sulfate. So many questions repeatedly asking. I don't know what they want to know. Their knowledge of students and their questions are. Pregnancy induced hypertension is the hypertension that develops after. Option A is 18 week. B is 20 weeks, C is 24 weeks, D is 28 weeks. Dr. Prakash.
A.
Wrong. 20 weeks of pregnancy. Here it's B is the option. Okay, my dear friends, such questions they ask. I already explained in my theory. So please concentrate on my theory. And I am sure you are able to solve MCQs about gestational hypertension. This is a very easy topic, but very high yield topic. If you want to write any exam, any examination like US Assembly, like NEET PG, like AIMS, any examination, please go through this table. You are going to definitely receive one question from this, maybe in pharmacology. In pharmacology, one question for those drugs, antihypertensive for in pregnancy. With those who are contraindicated, you are going to definitely get one question from this. And in gyne ops, you can definitely get a one question. So I am telling nearly three questions you are going to receive in examination with the help of this topic. So my dear friends, please go through this topic very well. This is a very high yield topic and very perfect. I try my best to explain this. I already explained so many things. So I hope we already solved some MCQs. Those are related with it past years. So my dear friends, thank you for your cooperation and thank you for your attendance, and I am very glad and very happy. If you have any questions, any suggestion, please put comments on my lecture, and if you like my video, please put like and subscribe my video if you haven't subscribed still now. So my dear friends, if you want to learn about any kind of topic, you can ask me a topic, you can write on my video, and I am ready to teach that topic also. Okay, my dear friends, have a good day. Thanks and good night. Goodbye.